So it really wasn't that many years ago that we didn't even have browser tabs. And you may have had a desktop look like this if you had a whole bunch of different windows open looking at different websites. But browser tabs caught on so quickly that anybody that started using them really doesn't face this problem anymore. So if you're still dealing with having multiple windows open, you may want to switch to using tabs and don't look back. So this is what it looks like without tabs. With tabs, we'll just use the handy merge all windows function. This is what it looks like. You get this one window here, and those same web pages are each in a different tab, and I can click on the tab to go to it. Each one exists separately, and I can actually click on something in one and it will start to load up on that one, and I can go to another one while that one's loading, go back to it, and it's completely loaded. So it makes it really easy to surf the web using multiple websites at the same time. Now, there's some tricks to using tabs. First, you want to have things set properly in Safari tabs. So here, this will tell you what's going to happen. So I've got it set to open pages and tabs instead of windows automatically. So when I click on a link that's supposed to open up a new window, it's going to open up a new tab instead. I could also use Command Click to open a link in a new tab. So this is different than, say, clicking on a link and it replaces the current page. So if I see something I want to go to but I don't want to leave the current page, I want to have both open, the new page and the one I'm looking at, I can Command Click on it instead. I can check here to have the new tab open and become active or stay on the current page. So that's depends on how you want it. And I can use Command 1 through Command 9 to switch tabs. So for instance, here I've got 5 tabs open. I can do Command 2, 3, 4, 5 to go through them all. Now there are also a few indications here of what will happen with these current settings. So here I see that Command Click will open a link in a new tab. A Command Shift Click opens a link in a new tab and makes it the active tab. So I do have the ability to do that even though I don't have this checked off. Command Option Click opens a link to a new window. So if I do want a new window open, I still can do that. I just need to know the right keyboard combination. And Option Shift Click with Command opens the link in a new window and makes it active, which makes sense. These kind of all build upon each other. So that's how you use different tabs. So if I wanted to go to a link, say, here at MacMost, if I click on this link, it will just simply replace the current tab with the new location and go back. If I Command Click, instead opens up another tab, you can see that there, and then I can move to it. So I can give it a few seconds to load while maybe I continue to read something on this page. If I go into Preferences and I have this one checked though, look at the difference here. I'm going to Command Click here. It will open it up and jump to it. So you may want to have that option there. Most people I think would. And that's basically how you use tabs. But once you have them open, you can close any tab without even going to it by moving your cursor over, and you see these little X's that appear as I move my cursor over each thing. And I can actually close a page, close a whole tab by clicking on that X, including the current page. So I can do that. I can drag the tabs around to change the order if I want to be organized. I can drag a tab out to have it be its own window. And I can use Merge All Windows here to merge everything back in to a single window. The one on the front will be the one that takes over everything and all the other tabs go into it. Also, if I want to go to a new location, so I need to type in here, what I want to do is use Command T or File New Tab, and it opens up a new tab that's empty, and I can go to the page I want by typing in normally. So that's how you do it without actually replacing something that's currently there. So those are the basics, but if you have your preferences set with all of these turned on, and open pages and tabs instead of windows automatically, then you pretty much are going to start using tabs anyway without having to do any of this special stuff. Things will just open in tabs. Everything will stay nice and neat in one window in Safari. And then your new challenge is going to be trying to keep the number of tabs down, because then instead of having tons of windows, you're going to find you have 18 or 30 or 50 different tabs open, which can get a little cluttered. And it's just easy to leave those tabs there. But remember, you can always go back to a website, just very easily, especially if you have it bookmarked or it's something you go to regularly. So it doesn't harm things usually, just to keep the tabs kind of neat and close them up. I like to try to just keep myself down to two or three tabs at a time unless I'm actually doing something specific where I need all those tabs open. Thank you.